Hello, Bloomington. I'm Mayor Tim Busse, and this is the Council Minute for the week of November 9th. The City Council had a busy night on Monday, starting with a study session at 5:30, followed by a regular meeting at 7 o'clock. This week, the City Council received an update on COVID-19 from our acting Public Health Administrator, Nick Kelly, and we received a presentation on the resident survey results from Diane Kirby, our Community Services Director. Let's start today with COVID-19. As Dr. Kelly told us on Monday night, the United States is on a dangerous trajectory with COVID-19 cases. We are on track for more than 200,000 new cases a day by the end of the year unless there is a substantial change in people's behaviors. In Minnesota, we're setting records almost daily. We are on an unsustainable rate of case growth. And the data in Bloomington is also moving rapidly in the wrong direction. This past weekend, we documented 178 new COVID-19 infections in Bloomington. Our average number of new cases in Bloomington over the past couple of weeks has been rapidly climbing, and it's higher now than it has ever been during this pandemic. Our 7-day rolling average of new cases per 100,000 is now routinely over 60 and accelerating, which is 3 times more new cases than we saw in the spring and the summer peaks in Bloomington. Conditions here have changed. Many activities that were less risky a few weeks ago are now much more risky. Most of the known sources of exposure are around social interactions, whether they're small gatherings or larger events. Simply put, gathering with people outside of your immediate household in social settings right now is a risky proposition. On Tuesday, Governor Tim Walz signed Executive Order 2096 to curb the spread of COVID-19. The order establishes capacity limits for private social gatherings, for bars, and for restaurants. It also closes dine-in services in bars and restaurants from 10 p.m. to 4 a.m. At the state level, according to the governor, more than 70% of COVID-19 outbreaks in Minnesota from June to November have a direct link back to weddings, private social gatherings, and late nights at bars and restaurants. Those new restrictions from the state, they will go into effect on Friday, November 13th at 10 p.m. And due to the spike in COVID-19 cases here in Bloomington, I'll be acting on Friday, November 13th, to reinitiate a local emergency declaration. A declaration by the mayor is effective for 3 days, so the City Council is expected to consider extending that emergency declaration on Monday, November 16th. Now, we had a local emergency in effect starting in March of this year. The Council and I allowed that declaration to expire at the end of June, but we said at the time and realized that it may be necessary to come back at a later date based on the conditions of this pandemic. Well, as I said, conditions have certainly changed, and they are frankly much worse than they were in the early months. The declaration will again empower our city manager, Jamie Verbrugge, and our emergency manager, Fire Chief Yuli Seal, to make decisions and to take actions more expeditiously than may otherwise be the case for things like purchasing, city operations, or other regulatory actions that are necessary for public health and for public safety. As Dr. Kelly and Governor Walz both have said, it does not have to be this way. We know how to live with COVID-19. We know what mitigation strategies work, and we know how to use them. Minnesota has a solid plan in place. The challenge we have now is that many are choosing not to follow public health guidance. Folks, many in our community have lost sight of how our individual actions impact the entire community, and that we're all striving for the same goal here. Their goal is to get through this pandemic. The path we are on jeopardizes the ability to provide in-person school for our youth. It jeopardizes the capacity and the type of medical care we have available for any emergency. It jeopardizes the health of our community, and it obviously jeopardizes our economy. Our common enemy here is COVID-19. It is not each other. I want to take this moment to specifically say that I strongly support the actions the Bloomington School Board took this past Monday to protect the students and the staff in our schools, and ultimately to protect the community. The Bloomington School Board voted this week to shift back to distance learning for all elementary school students. The last day of hybrid learning is November 20th. Middle and high school students will continue in their distance learning mode. Other programs and activities that will cease in-person gatherings on November 20th include early learning services, elementary and middle school, after-school targeted services, and facility rentals. Kids Safari will be scaled down to required childcare only. The Jefferson and Kennedy High School's fall sports teams, football and volleyball, they will be allowed to complete their season, including the playoffs. But winter sports and activities will shift to a virtual-only format until further notice. The district's learning model, school programs, and activities affected by this decision will be reevaluated in early January 2021. School boards across the state, and certainly here in Bloomington, are being put into a really tough spot. I believe the Bloomington schools did the right thing to protect the community. Look, we need to change something so our community understands the importance of uniting around COVID-19. As your elected leaders in Bloomington, we're asking for your help to control COVID-19. Obviously, this is very concerning as we approach the holidays and the indoor season in general. Please, think of alternative ways to have your gatherings this year. And we can't say it enough. Keep your distance, keep interaction short, and please, please, please wear a mask. The city has pulled together resources to help our residents stay healthy and to lower their risk of COVID-19 this winter. Visit blm.mn/winter to learn more. For the past couple installments of the Council Minute, I provided brief looks into some of the results in the 2020 annual resident survey. This past Monday, the City Council received the full presentation, and all of the survey data is now available online for you to review. The web address for the survey info is here. Please do take a look. We've conducted the resident survey every year since 2012, and the survey gives the City Council and staff some valuable insights into how you, our residents, how you relate to your local government, how you relate to the community, and how you relate to the environment around you. And then, of course, we're able to use that data to help inform our decision making. This year gave us some really interesting data to chew on. For example, it was pretty clear that the pandemic and the protests around racial justice had an impact on our community. Economic stability and people's view on their financial prospects have clearly been affected by the economic fallout from COVID-19. Meanwhile, people's concerns for addressing social, economic, and racial equity differences in education, criminal justice, and health, they are all top priorities. Community safety also continues to be a top priority, with people expressing that they feel very safe in their own neighborhoods, but they're concerned about the overall sense of safety in the community. Our city staff, they received an 86% approval rating for their customer service. That's an all-time high that achieved one of our strategic goals around quality service delivery by exceeding an 85% annual approval rating. Well done, staff. Thank you. And as the City Council is approaching decisions on the 2021 budget and tax levy, one of the most reassuring results is that 70% of survey respondents feel that the value of city services for the taxes paid is a good deal. That number is higher than the national benchmark of communities around the country, and in fact, it's in the top 10% nationally. There is a lot more information in the resident survey for us to look at and dissect and to understand as we plan for next year and frankly for the next generation. Thank you to everyone who were randomly selected and who participated and gave us your feedback. It does matter to us what you think. Well, that's a wrap for this edition of the Council Minute. We'll see you next week. Please, Bloomington, stay safe.